Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to convert a binary number to decimal number in C++. So let's get started. So first let me explain you in a whiteboard. So after explaining you, I will like code it in C++ program. So first thing, let me show you an example what we are doing over here. So let's consider a binary number. So a binary number, you know, it's going to be in the form of zeros and ones. But let me consider four ones. Okay, this is going to be a binary number. So this number is in decimal form, it is 15. Okay. So now let me show you how we are deriving it. Okay, from this we will be like easily extracting our C++ code. So the simple way to extract the decimal number from binary number is we will be multiplying by the powers of 2. So at first we will be multiplying the first digit like this number with 1, and next we will multiply this number, the second number, with 2, and the third number with 4, and the next number with 8. So here you can see there is a pattern, right? At initially it was 1, then this number is multiplied by 2, we get 2, and this number is multiplied by 2, we get 4, and this number is multiplied by 2, we get 8. So for this we will be needing a variable. So we need a variable for this. Alright. So after that we will just sum this. So it's going to be 1 plus 2 plus 8 plus 4. So this will basically give us 15. So for this increasing number of powers, we need a variable to handle that. As well, we also need a variable to extract the last digit. Okay, we'll be extracting the last digit from each number. Like we'll be extracting this digit, we'll be extracting this digit. So for that we need another variable, and the final variable is going to be the number itself, because here we will be using a simple while loop. Okay, it's going to be like this. At first we will have four ones, so we will extract the last digit and we will basically multiply it with 1, so that number will be, sum will be equal to 1, and later then we will be removing this particular last digit. So at the end of the first while loop, our number is going to be 111, and next we will be doing the same thing. So we will extract this last digit, which is going to be 1, we will multiply it by 2 right now, so 2. And the sum will be equal to 3, 1 plus 2, this is going to be 3 at the end. And later we will be completely removing the last digit. So after that it's going to be 11, we will extract the last digit, 1 asterisk 4, because 4, yeah. So it's going to be 4, sum equal to 1 plus 7, and we will neglect the digit. And at last we will be having only 1, 1 into 8 will give us 8. So 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, which will be equal to 15. And after that, our while loop will terminate when we neglect this digit as well. Our number will be basically equal to 0 at the end. So this program is quite similar to finding the sum of digits, reversing a number, exactly the same criteria of the steps that we will be using in this as well. So now let's jump into the code. So as I told you, we will be needing these many variables over here. One variable for this power, one variable for extracting the last digit, and I think pretty much that's another variable for finding the sum. Sum is basically the decimal number at the end, that is the sum. So now let's jump into the code. So first thing, the variable or the number of binary digit. So you can get the input from the user. I will just manually have it. I will go with 4 ones. Yeah, so this is going to be our binary number. So next, what variable did I say? I said the variable for power. So this variable starts from 1. Okay, this is the initial value. So I will go with, I will have int p for power equal to 1. And next variable is going to be for remainder, for storing this last digit. Okay, so for that, let me have it as int last digit, or let me have it as remainder. That's going to be our remainder. Okay, and next is going to be the sum. Sum is going to be our, at the end our sum will have the decimal number in it. So let me initialize sum equal to 0 to avoid any junk value. So next, as I told you, we will be having here a while loop with condition n greater than 0. Okay, so it's going to be while n greater than 0. All right so first thing, what I told you is we will have the number and we'll be extracting the last digit from this binary number or the input number. So for extracting the last digit, what we will do is R, which is our remainder, or the last digit. I will name it as last digit. That will be fine. Last or first digit, something like that. I will name it as last digit. Yeah, last digit equal to our number modulus of 10. So our number is n modulus 10. Okay, this is practically same. Okay, so this is just like simple stuff. Okay, so let's suppose that I have a number 123. 123 mod 10. Mod 10 will give us 3. So by doing modulus of 10, we will be basically getting the last digit. We will be extracting the last digit. Our number n will remain this, but we will be getting the 3 as the output stored in our last digit. So this is how you do it for extracting the last digit from any number, just do modulus of 10. I hope that made sense. So after this, what I told you, after this, we will be multiplying it with this value, this power value. So, and we will be adding it with sum. So it's going to be sum equal to sum, that is our initial sum is 0, that's why I'm adding here sum plus what I told you, we'll be multiplying with the power variable, our last digit into our power variable. That's how we get 1, 2, 4, and 8 over here. Okay, we'll be multiply this with this thing. So it's going to be sum plus our last digit asterisk our power variable is P. Okay, I hope this made sense. And next thing what we need to do is, we need to like increment our power variable. So here you can see, right, our power variable value is 1 at first, then 2, then 4 and 8. So it increases by 2 times for every iteration, 1, 2, 4, 8. So it gets multiplied by 2. So in that case, what we need to do is, power variable equal to power variable asterisk 2. We are just multiplying by 2. You can use the power function as well, but I am just going multiplying by 2, which is both same case. Power function, it makes it complex. We need to import some header files, I guess. So this is just standard P equal to P asterisk 2. Simple. And the final thing, what I told you, we will be like, after like we have now done with the sum, we have extracted the last digit, multiplied with our power variable, increased our power variable value as well, incremented it by 2 as well, 2 times. So final thing, we need to like remove the last digit of our n. Okay, so for that, we'll be using n equal to n slash 10. So by this way, we will be like removing the last digit. Okay, so let's suppose that I have 123 as my number, 123 slash 10 will be equal to 12, just the quotient. Okay, quotient, and we are assigning that 12 to the n itself. So n, which was 123, like an example, after dividing by 10, it becomes 12. So n becomes 12 at the end of this line. So this statement is basically used to like remove the last digit. This is to extract the last digit. So both are different. Okay, so that's it pretty much. That's the code, to be honest. So now I'll just put C out. Some will have the decimal number. That's the code. So if you, I will run this first and show you. After that, I will explain you how this works in a brief way. So if I run it, I need to get 15 in the output. Yeah, 15. I've got 15. So what are the other numbers? I saw so many numbers. Let's go with 1001 1011. Okay, 1001 1011. Okay, so we need to get 155 for that. So 155. So this is working absolutely fine. So now let me go with a simple demo. Yeah, so what happens at first, n is 4 ones. Okay, I will have a comment. So you do initial value, n is 41. Okay, n equal to 4 ones. So n value is greater than 0, while loop condition, this condition is true. Okay, so it goes to the last digit. So at first, our last digit equal to 4 ones modulus of 10. So this will give us the last digit. Last digit is 1. So this LD value is going to be either 0 or 1. So in case of our number is 0, this is going to be number. This LD value will be 0 because it's absolutely divisible by 10. So since it is not divisible by 10, we will be having a remainder over here. I hope that made sense. Last digit is 1. So this is during the first iteration. After this, it comes here, sum equal to, initially our sum is 0, so it's going to be 0 plus last digit is 1 asterisk our power. Our power variable is 1 at first, because here I told you, right, it starts from 1 to 8, 4 and 8. So it's going to be 1 asterisk 1. Okay, so our sum, initially our sum is, will be equal to 0 plus 1. Our sum is going to be 1. So our power variable, power equal to, power variable initial value is 1. And it's going to be 1 asterisk 2. We are multiplying by 2. So it's going to be 2 at the end. And our number, n equal to 4 ones slash 10, which is equal to 111. Okay, I told you last digit will be getting removed. So this is during the first iteration. Then it goes again. Our number is 111 now, not 4 ones. So it goes here. Our number n, 111 mod 10. Same thing, same 1. So it goes here. Sum equal to sum plus. This time our previous sum is 1. Okay, it's not 0. So this will be 1. Last digit is 1 over here. Last digit is fine. But our power variable value is 2 over here. So it's going to be 1 asterisk 2 over here. And so 1 plus 2. So our sum is going to be 3 right now. And after that, power variable value. So power variable value was 2 earlier. So it's going to be 2 asterisk 2, which is going to be 4 now. And as I told you, our n is 111. So 111 slash 10 is going to give us 11. So again goes here, 11 here. 11 here as well. Last digit is 1 and sum equal to, our sum is 3 earlier, so it's going to be 3. Our power digit is 4 from the previous iteration, so it's going to be 4. So 3 plus 1 asterisk 4, which is going to 3 plus 4, which is 7. 4 asterisk 2 will give us 8 over here, and our number was 11 and it's going to be 1 at the end. So 1 is still greater than 0. True. 1 mod 10 is 1. Okay, 1 mod 10 is not 0. 1 mod 10 is 1. So it comes here, our sum from previous iteration is 7, last digit is same 1, our power value is 8, yeah, put 8 over here. So 7 plus 1 asterisk 8 will give us 15, which is the decimal form of our binary number. And after this, power variable will become 8 asterisk 2, which is 16, but no use, we are not going to do anything with this, because after this particular loop, while loop is going to terminate, it's going to be false. So no use of this value 16. So number was 1. 1 slash 10 is 0. Okay. So at the end of this, our number will become 0 and n will become 0 over here as well. So 0 greater than 0 condition is false. While loop breaks, our sum, which is our decimal number, gets printed. And no, as it, that's the reason why I told you no use of this 16. So this is how it works. A simple code, quite easy. Like, you need to just imagine and write it down first in a whiteboard or a paper, and you need to just work it through that way. And I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.